I have here with me Tomás Kelly, who's just played a great role here in Aina Kilmona's win over Feakle, down here on Six Mile Bridge. I don't think you're going to get a tougher game than that, Tomás. You've played in a good few games. That was a seriously hard game.
No, I suppose we knew that. We knew we were going to get an awful hard game against Feakle. When the draw was made, we would have played a lot against Feakle over the years. Played 21 finals against them. And there was never more than a puck of the ball between us. So we kind of knew the battle we were going to be in today, and probably lucky to get the right side of it, so we're delighted.
Yeah, absolutely. To be in a county semi-final now is huge for this club, because, you know, relatively new club, I suppose, and, you know, we've achieved an awful lot, but this is a big thing now to be getting into county semi-final. The match itself, I suppose, when you go back to it, the Breeze had a big bearing in the game, and the Feakle played with the Breeze in the first half, and they made hay, I suppose. While they had that Breeze early on, they went up 4 points at one stage. We pulled it back to 3 before half time, which was important. 3 points seemed manageable enough, Tomás.
Yeah, well, I suppose, in fairness, the Feakle did most of the hurling done in the first half, and they probably deserved to be more up. So, you know, we were probably relatively happy that we were only down by the 3 at half time, and just important not to panic. We knew that if we kept chipping away at the lead like that, you know, there's going to be a long 30, 32, 35 minutes in the second half. So just important for the lads, like, that maybe over the years that we might have panicked in situations like that. Like, so it was good that we didn't panic and we kept positive.
Yeah, but James got the goal there. It was all important goal, like, that really kept it, you know, it kept it to a goal in, I suppose, at the end, at half time. That was very important. The second half then, like, we had the Breeze. Yeah, it took us a while to get going into that second half, but when we did, I thought we played by far the better hurling in that second half, and yet the freeze seemed to keep them in it, especially those two late frees. I couldn't understand that.
Yeah, but look, we're not going to comment on that now, but look, the referee makes his decision. You just have to put the ball down and get on with it, and like, they have a lethal free taker in Shane McGrath. He's going to score from everywhere. He'll score from play as well. So no, we're just delighted that we showed a small bit of character, but at the end of the day, we've nothing won. We're into semi-final. We're delighted to be there, and we have to drive on from this now.
Yeah, I suppose a lot of their scores came from Shane McGrath, and he's an exceptional player, we have to say that. And you know, they're not a one-man band by any means. But I suppose, I said it to Fergal earlier on, character was the main thing that I took out of it, watching above in the stand there. I mean, it was a few occasions when I felt like, you know, it's going to be difficult to win this game. And it did prove to be difficult. But when it ended up at a draw, then after the 60 minutes, 60 plus minutes, you know, I suppose there's sort of the real character of this team came out to eke out that win, like, in extra time.
Yeah, I suppose, like, maybe that's one of the things that maybe we haven't shown in the past, and maybe our own people would be very critical of us in terms of that, like, but we were positive, and we decided that we were just going to show a bit of composure as well. That was one of the things the management spoke during the week, like, that, you know, whether we were 5 points up or 5 points down, we were just going to show a bit of composure and not panic. That, you know, you have to keep going until the referee blows the final whistle. So, look, we're delighted to get through into the semi-final, but we've a huge amount of improvement to do.
Yeah, but, yes, when you look at the forward line, Aidan McCarthy got 3 points. Jason got two, I think, from midfield. Evan Mack came up with 2 points, two great points. Jerry Arthur, I think he came up with 4, maybe 5 points, you know. So the scores were coming. James Harlan got 1-4, I think. So, you know, everyone was contributing really, like, to the scoreline, which is, and maybe more so, than our forwards seem to be the best forward line in it, would say.
Yeah, well, I suppose, you know, we need to get an even spread of scores from our forwards. We know that we're not going anywhere unless everyone chips in with one or two legs. So, you know, we're not a one-man team. I suppose the strength of our team really is our panel. Like, you know, if you go down to 23, 24, 25, like, the competition for places, like, we've never really had it. We've always had maybe the 15. But, like, this year, like, you can see, lads, like, the strength of our panel is unbelievable. Like, and, yeah, you know, our intermediate team are in the county quarterfinal tomorrow, like, and we wish them the best of luck as well.
That's right, absolutely. Maybe then we can continue the winning streak. In the county semi-final, Tomás, Senior, one step away from a county final. That's a huge place for this team to be. We haven't been there before, not this particular team. So it's a few hectic weeks ahead, I suppose.
Yeah, well, I suppose the last time we were there was about 7 years ago. So it's too long really for a club of our size to be away from that. So look, we have to get the heads down now. We have to recover. We know we've got a lot of improvement to do on today's performance. Get back training on Tuesday night.
Yeah, most people would say that with the success we've had at minor and especially under 21, that the next natural step was to get into, you know, to get into the position we're in now. So it shouldn't be a huge surprise. I know you think that we're critical of you, but we're not really. We value what you do out on the pitch.
Yeah, look, it's you know, we've had a lot of success underage, but it's not so easy to translate it. Like, you can see a lot of, you know, other inter-county teams and, you know, club teams, like, it's not a magic wand you can wave where you can go straight from having a load of underage success to senior success. So, you know, we always knew it was going to be hard, but if we could make a breakthrough and stay with the top boys, you know, we'd be delighted, really.
Yeah, I believe you're going to the Hinch for the evening now, too, because it was very warm out there, I'm sure, and, you know, it was a hard battle, like, so I'd say a recovery session is in order.
Yeah, we'll get into the sea anyway, and we'll see where we go after that.
Yeah, hopefully not to Listenverne anyway. But,
yeah, maybe not. No, it's too far north for me.
A bit too far north. Tomás, you played a vital role there from the middle of the park, Tomás, and, you know, we're very proud of what you've achieved today, and we're delighted that it'll really get the parish moving now, and we look forward to the next day out.
Okay, thanks, Nicholas.